Well, in my opinion, I think Wilkes 85 is going to be drooling over this video when he sees this. This is a vintage Sears 1981-ish combination stereo with speakers. Of course, it has the AM/FM stereo, the 8-track player, the cassette player, and the phonograph or turntable. I got these from a local elderly moving sale yesterday afternoon for $10. And the reason why they were so cheap is because the record changer or turntable did not work. I already got the record changer working again, and now it works pretty good. It needed to be re-lubricated and an idler wheel installed, which I got off a BSR changer. Yeah, now the changer works great. And this system is in phenomenal shape. It's nice and clean. The people that had this took very good care of it. This system looks almost mint. The dust cover for the record changer is in very nice shape, hardly scratched at all. It's nice and clear. Usually these things are pretty smoked up and pretty scratched up, but this cover is in awesome shape. You don't find too many covers like this. It came with a record brush, the 45 RPM adapter, and as a bonus, the original owner's manual too. God, I love these elderly sale scores. They're a dying breed. After 20 years, all these scores will be gone, so stock up on them while you can, once you find them. Because when they're gone, they're gone. I predict in 20 years, most yard sales will sell crap, so stock up on the good stuff while you can. The speakers are in nice shape. I think they're two-way speakers. The cloth's in nice shape. Beautiful shape. The fake veneer is in great shape too. The 8-track player does work alright. It could use some maintenance. It has a few issues. The cassette player does work good too. It could use some maintenance too. Probably head cleaning and capstan cleaning or capstan roller cleaning. It could use. Along with the dial, the station dial on the front, it also has an LED readout for the stations too, which is pretty cool. And I'll give you a demonstration. I'll turn the unit on. That's enough for the radio demonstration. It could use an antenna though. And I'll test out the 8-track player. What the hell? Serving USA. I don't want to play too much of that because of the copyright cops, but yeah, the 8-track player could use some maintenance, otherwise it works okay. And I don't know if I have a cassette that's WMG or whatever approved, so I'm not going to demonstrate that. I'll demonstrate the record changer, hold on. As you see here, I got an LP record on the record changer for demonstration purposes, and I'll move the lever here to start, like that. Thank you. and I'll move the lever towards the center. The automatic works great. The only two drawbacks about this record changer is you have to have the cabinet on a level surface for the tone arm to drop properly. If you got the cabinet on level, the tone arm may drop kind of off. And plus, there's only 33 and 45 RPM speeds on this changer. Usually most changers like this have 16, 33, 45, and 78 speeds. But oh well, otherwise the changer works great. And that concludes this video. Have a good night. Bye.